Hi, this is Arash and welcome to Epoxy channel. In this channel, we're going to talk about the epoxies from the theoretical aspects to the most practical ones. So if this is the first video that you're watching, or if you're interested in epoxies, please like and subscribe to our channel for more videos.
Today, I'm going to talk about diluents and solvents for epoxy resins. Solvent and diluents are used to lower the viscosity of epoxy resin systems, either to permit easy compounding with other ingredients or to aid in the application of the adhesives onto substrate. Both solvents and diluents are low molecular weight liquid compounds that are chemically and physically compatible with epoxy resins and their curing agents. Solvents have a relatively high vapor pressure and are intended to eventually evaporate from the system. Diluents have much lower vapor pressures and generally do not evaporate at ambient conditions. Two distinct classes of diluents are used with epoxy resins: non-reactive diluents and reactive diluents. Reactive diluents will enter into the cross-linking reaction with the primary resin, and non-reactive diluents will not. Non-reactive diluents primarily act as a low molecular weight plasticizer for the epoxy composition. Important factors for solvents and diluents in epoxy system include their evaporation rates, solvent strength, and dispersion powers, as different epoxy resins, curing agents, and possible organic additives may be used within a formulation. The choice of solvent or diluent is made with regard to the solubility of individual components and the viscosity, drying times, and wetting characteristic required for the final product. All these properties affect the bond performance of the resulting epoxy. Solvents are employed in epoxy formulation to aid in dispersing, mixing, and wetting of components in the resin system, or to liquefy the solid epoxy resins and reduce the viscosity for the application stage. In this regard, solvent may need to solubilize more than one component, for example, resin, curing agent, or polymeric additive. Often, a blend of solvent is necessary to achieve the required degree of solubility or to provide for certain processing conditions, for example, drying time. Polar solvents are required with polar resins, nonpolar solvents with nonpolar resins. Water is also sometimes used as a solvent for water-soluble resins, for example, to disperse epoxy particles in an emulsion. Once the adhesive is applied, the solvent must evaporate prior to cure. Otherwise, bubbles or vapor pockets could form, causing a physically weak joint with poor adhesion in adhesives. The solvent in the adhesive formulation must not adversely affect the substrate. Plastic, elastomers, and polymeric foams are especially sensitive to certain solvents used in epoxy adhesives. The choice of solvent for a particular epoxy formulation will primarily depend on the method of application, brush, spray, travel, etc., the nature of the epoxy resins, and the interaction between the solvent and constituent in the formulations, the desired viscosity and solids content of the final product, and the sensitivity of the substrate surface to the solvent. Examples of solvents typically used in epoxy adhesive systems are acetone, methyl ethyl ketone, toluene, xylene, glycol ethers, and alcohols. Generally, the efficiency of the solvent declines with increasing epoxy molecular weight. Solvent blends normally consisting of combinations of fast evaporating and slow evaporating solvents. They're often used in epoxy system in a combination. Fast evaporating solvents are based on low boiling point ketones, and slow evaporating solvents are based on higher boiling point compounds. True solvents are solvents capable of diluting resin to any degree without resin precipitation. True solvents for epoxy include MEK, diacetone alcohol, methyl cyclohexanone, and most glycol ethers and their acetates. Aromatic solvents such as toluene and xylene, as well as simple alcohols such as isopropyl and N-butyl alcohol, are not active solvents for diglycetyl ether bisphenol A resins. However, they can be used in combination with other solvents to improve solubility. Improper selection of a solvent can cause problems such as vapor entrapment in the cured adhesives, substrate damage, and poor film forming properties in the coatings. By proper combination of solvents, it is possible to reduce the viscosity while preserving the solids content at a given percent. Even with employing a proper balanced solvent, still some solvents may remain entrapped in the cured resin unless the cure is preceded by an elevated temperature exposure to eliminate the solvent. Some of the solvents that are commonly used in epoxy resin can present a flammability hazard and a special health hazard, and the SES document of the solvents may be reviewed for proper handling. It should be mentioned that hydroxyl compounds such as water, alcohols, or phenols act as catalysts and accelerate the curing. However, these solvents are not serious competitors with amines for reacting with the epoxy ring. Aromatic hydrocarbons or mineral spritz have no effect on the amine epoxy resins and behaves as inert diluents. Carbonyl solvents such as acetone and methyl ethyl ketone retard the reaction. Therefore, solvent may potentially affect the cure processes. The pot life, penetration, film formation, adhesion, and other critical properties. Diluents are higher molecular weight compounds than solvent that are added to the epoxy adhesive formulations to lower the viscosity and modify processing conditions. Diluents can be used in epoxy coatings as well. They are used to reduce the viscosity, facilitate the compounding with fillers, improve filler loading capacity, or improve application properties. The effect of various diluents on the initial viscosity of diglycetyl ether of bisphenol A epoxy resins has been presented here. Diluents promotes adhesion and also increase the working life by increasing the time that the mixture viscosity is below a workable limit and decreasing the reactivity of the curing agent, primarily because of the dilution of the resin. Diluents will also affect the performance properties of the epoxy. They lower the degree of cross-linking, and this reduction increasing the resiliency of the adhesives or epoxy system. However, it reduces tensile strain as well as heat and chemical resistance. These effects are more pronounced at elevated temperature than at room temperature. The degree of these effects will depend on whether a non-reactive diluent or a reactive diluent has been employed. Reactive diluents are generally preferred over non-reactive diluent because they are chemically linked to the epoxy network. However, they still degrade the physical properties because their functionality is lower than that of resin. Non-reactive diluents can be touted as a plasticizers. Because non-reactive diluents are relatively mobile, they can more easily migrate on heating or vacuum degassing. If this occurs during cure, the result is a greater shrinkage and appearance of vapor bubbles. This results in reduced adhesive strain because of the created internal stresses. Therefore, both reactive and non-reactive diluents should be used with care if the properties of the cured system are to be preserved. An amount of 5 to 10 pph is best and generally provide a sharp reduction in viscosity. Diluents are generally not as much a problem as solvent concerning the health risk, but they are low viscosity, relatively high vapor pressure compounds and could lead to irritation in certain applications. Non-reactive diluents do not react with the resins or curing agent. In a sense, they act as plasticizers to the epoxy network. In addition to lowering the viscosity, non-reactive diluents are often used to balance the mix ratio proportion in certain epoxy systems. However, non-reactive diluents have not found wide acceptance in epoxy adhesive technology, primarily because most are incompatible with the cured resin. More often, similar effect can be achieved by proper selection of a long-chain curing agent or a reactive diluent. Nonyl phenol, furfural alcohol, and diburyl phthalate are common non-reactive diluents for epoxy systems. Diburyl phthalate is a commonly used non-reactive diluent because it does not exhibit migratory tendencies on aging. It is generally incorporated into diglycidyl ether bisphenol A epoxy with heating. When it is used at about 20 ppH, the viscosity of the resin can be reduced almost 5 folds. Diburyl phthalate also provides flexibility but reduces the cross-linking density of the resin. The improved flexibility results in improved adhesion and thermal shock resistance, but at the sacrifice of elevated temperature performance. Nonyl phenol is a non-reactive phenolic diluent that can be added to diglycidyl ether bisphenol A epoxy resins in concentration up to 40 ppH. It is different from butyl phthalate in that the phenolic groups can accelerate the epoxy amine curing reaction. Nonyl phenol is most commonly used with aliphatic primary amine and polyamide curing agents to reduce the viscosity of the system and accelerate the curing reaction. The gel time is reduced and the exotherm increases with the addition of nonyl phenol to the diglycidyl ether bisphenol A resin. Since non-reactive diluents do not enter into the cross-linking reaction, they can be lost due to volatilization, especially when exposed to the elevated temperatures of the exotherm or curing cycle. If vaporization does occur, shrinkage of the adhesive film happens, resulting in internal stresses within the joint. These internal stresses reduces the degree of adhesion. Most non-reactive diluents are used in concentration of 5 to 20% by weight of the epoxy resins. The general effect of incorporating non-reactive diluent is to increase the working life and decrease the peak exotherms. The effect of the cured properties is generally negative, although at low additions the effect is relatively small. In the cured resins, non-reactive diluent will lead to an increase in the impact strength but a decrease in the thermal and chemical resistance and tensile strength. Some non-reactive diluents have been used to impact special properties on the cured epoxy in addition to lowering the viscosity of the uncured system. For example, chlorinated diluents have been used with antimony oxide to impart flame resistance to cured epoxy resins. Reactive diluents enter into the polymerization reaction of the epoxy resins and the curing agent. In this way, the final adhesive characteristics are determined by the reaction product of the resins and the diluent. The most common reactive diluent used for epoxy adhesive formulation are shown in table. Most reactive diluents are mono or difunctional. They are made by reacting epichlorohydrin with an alcohol, a phenol or a polyol to produce a mono or polyglycidyl ether resin. However, there are some non-epoxy diluents that are used as well. These non-epoxy diluents generally react with the curing agent or other functional groups in the epoxy chain. In addition to the viscosity reduction, the presence of reactive diluents generally leads to a faster rate of cure. In fact, by lowering the viscosity, the molecules become more mobile in the earlier stages of cure, which result in a more reactive system. The primary reactive diluents are mono-epoxy, low molecular weight epoxy resins. These may be used to rather high concentrations with little effect on cured properties. Often they are embedded to make selective improvement on the certain properties, such as adhesion, thermal cycling resistance, and impact strength. The monofunctional epoxy diluents are essentially chain stoppers since they inhibit crosslink from forming. The extent to which the cured properties are affected is directly dependent on the concentration of the diluent added to the epoxy resin. The general effect is to reduce viscosity and improve the impact and thermal shock resistance while slightly reducing the thermal resistance. Monofunctional epoxy diluents are used primarily with diglycidyl ether epoxy blends. The most common monofunctional diluents are butyl glycidyl ether and phenyl glycidyl ether. Because the monofunctional diluents reduce crosslink density, they are used at relatively low levels to avoid degrading heat and chemical resistance or other properties of the epoxy. Difunctional epoxy diluents are low viscosity, low molecular weight epoxy resins. These diluents may be used at very high concentrations and they do not greatly affect the properties of the cured resins. In some instances, the difunctional epoxy diluents will actually improve properties. These materials include butandien dioxide, vinyl cyclohexane dioxide, and diglycidyl ether of resorcinol. Long-chain polyether polyols such as polypropylene glycol, when reacted with epichlorohydrine, produce a di-epoxy resin with an internal polyether chain that serve both to decrease viscosity and to increase flexibility. It should also be noted that there are several reactive diluents exist that do not contain epoxy groups. Other non-epoxy containing reactive diluents may be co-curing agents, unsaturated molecules, active hydrogen containing molecules, materials that are capable of performing transesterification with available hydroxyl groups, and materials capable of reacting with the curing agents. It should also be pointed out that solvents and diluents are not the only ways to lower the viscosity of filled epoxy resin systems. Surface active agents can also be added to reduce the viscosity. They provide better bedding of the filler by the epoxy resin matrix. This can lead to substantial viscosity reduction for system having equivalent filler concentration. The surface active agent in turn could also be used to produce formulation with higher filler loading at equivalent viscosity.
Thanks for your attention. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please share your thoughts, comments, or questions, and I will see you soon.